Welcome to my class. In today's class, we are going to discuss about one of the important systems in the human body. That is, the circulatory system is also called as cardiovascular system. This organ system permits the blood to transport the nutrition, enzymes, oxygen, carbon dioxide, and remove the toxic substance and transport to all parts of the body. In another way, this is the process, the movement of the nutrition, enzymes, hormones, and the toxic substance in a liquid state. It's also called as a circulatory system. In the circulatory system, we are going to see three major parts. The three major parts are the heart, the blood, and the blood vessels. In today's class, we are going to discuss the first part of the circulatory system, that is the heart. To make the concept easier, today we will go with a technology called augmented reality. It is nothing but the AR. Come, let us explore with the heart. Heart is present between two lungs, towards little left. Heart is one of the vital organs of our body. Heart helps us in circulating the blood to all parts of the body. The length of the heart is 10 cm. And moving on to the size. The size depends upon the individual's left arm fist. So this will be the size of the heart of mine. So it depends upon the individual. The weight. The weight is 300 to 350 grams in an average. It is. The heart is covered by the pericardium. Its main function is to transport the blood to all parts of the body. Per minute, 70 milliliters of blood is pumped. 70 to 72 times the heart beats in a minute. Per minute, 5 liters blood is being pumped. So, in the circulatory system, the heart is one of the major organs which plays a very, very, very important role. Come, let us explore with and how the mechanism of the blood circulation which takes inside the heart. Before discussing the circulation of the blood in the heart, we will see the parts of the human heart. The human heart has four chambers, that is the right auricle, right ventricle, left auricle, and the left ventricle. These are the four chambers of the heart. The auricles and the ventricles are being divided by two walls, that is the tricuspid wall and the bicuspid wall. We have two vena cavas. When I say the vena cavas, it is the large vessels. When I say the vena cavas, it says that it is the large vessels. So we have two large vessels, that is the superior vena cava and the inferior vena cava. Inside the heart, we have pulmonary artery and the pulmonary vein. And at last, we have aorta in the top. We have aorta in the top which circulate the purified blood, that is the oxygenated blood, to all part of the body. Yes, come. Now let's see the mechanism of circulation in the heart of the blood. Yes, as I said earlier, the two vena cavas, that is the superior and the inferior vena cava. When I say superior, the superior vena cava which brings the impure blood, that is the deoxygenated blood, from the head and the chest level, and it is above the heart. And when I say the inferior vena cava which brings the deoxygenated blood from below the heart level to the first chamber. The first chamber of the heart is the right artery. So when I say the right auricle, the impure blood comes to the first chamber and it is being filled. Once when it is filled, there is an automatic valve open, that is the tricuspid valve opens. The tricuspid valve opens. From the right auricle, it moves to the right ventricle, that is the deoxygenated blood from the first chamber, it moves to the second chamber, that is the right ventricle. Here, with the help of the pulmonary artery, here is the only artery which carries the impure blood. So, from the ventricle, the impure blood is being transported to the lungs through the pulmonary artery. So, in the lungs, the blood gets oxygen, that is the blood is oxygenated, and with the help of the pulmonary vein, it comes back to the heart. Here is the only vein where it carries pure blood. In all the other conditions, the vein carries impure blood. So with the help of the pulmonary vein, from the lungs, the pure blood comes to the third chamber, and that is the left auricle. So the purified blood is going to the third chamber, that is the left auricle, and the blood is filled in that chamber. Once the chamber is filled, again there is a valve which opens automatically. That valve is called the bicuspid valve. So the valve is open and the purified blood, that is the oxygenated blood, goes to the last chamber. It goes to the last chamber. So from the last chamber, it should go to all part of the body, that is with the help of aorta. With the help of aorta, the purified blood, that is the oxygenated blood, is being circulated to all parts of the body. This is all about the mechanism of circulation of the blood in the heart. To make it very simple, two valves, that is superior and inferior vena cava, bring back all the impure blood, that is deoxygenated blood, to the first chamber, right auricle. From the right auricle, the tricuspid valve opens, it goes to the right ventricle. Then with the help of pulmonary artery, it goes to the lungs. The deoxygenated blood gets oxygenated. The oxygenated blood with the help of pulmonary vein comes back to the heart, that is the right ventricle. From there, the bicuspid valve opens. The bicuspid valve opens. Then it goes to the ventricle, and from there, with the help of the aorta, the oxygenated blood is circulated to the all part of the body. So this is all about the today's class. In today's class, we saw what is the circulatory system and the three major parts, that is the heart, the blood vessels. In that, we saw the first part of the circulatory system, the major part, that is the heart, that is one of the vital organs of the human body. And that, with the help of the AR technology, we explore and make this concept more easier to understand. So I think so with this technology, the concept of the mechanism of circulation of the blood in the heart made much easier to understand. With the same technology, we will meet in the next class and explore with the other two major parts, that is the blood and the blood vessels. Thank you so much.